Ndrangheta. The Ndrangheta is a mafia-type organized crime group based in Calabria, Italy. Despite not being as famous abroad as the Sicilian Mafia, and having been considered more rural than the Neapolitan Camorra and the Apulian Sacra Corona Unita, the Ndrangheta became the most powerful crime syndicate in Italy in the late 1990s and early 2000s. While commonly tied together with the Sicilian Mafia, the Ndrangheta operates independently from them, though there is contact between the two, due to the geographical proximity and shared culture and language between Calabria and Sicily. A U.S. diplomat estimated that the organization's narcotics trafficking, extortion and money laundering activities accounted for at least 3% of Italy's GDP in 2010. Since the 1950s, the organization has spread towards northern Italy and worldwide. According to a 2013 threat assessment on Italian organized crime of Europol, the Ndrangheta is among the richest and most powerful organized crime groups at a global level. In 1861, the prefect of Reggio Calabria already noticed the presence of so-called camorristi, a term used at the time since there was no formal name for that phenomenon in Calabria. Since the 1880s, there is ample evidence of Ndrangheta-type groups in police reports and sentences by local courts. At the time, they were often being referred to as the Picchietteria, Onorata Società or Camorra and Mafia. These secret societies in the areas of Calabria rich in olives and vines were distinct from the often anarchic forms of banditry and were organized hierarchically with the code of conduct that included a murder, the code of silence, according to a sentence from the court in Reggio Calabria in 1890. An 1897 sentence from the court in Palmi mentioned the written code of rules found in the village of Seminaro based on honor, secrecy, violence, solidarity and mutual assistance. In the folk culture surrounding Ndrangheta in Calabria, references to the Spanish Garduña often appear. Aside from these references, however, there is nothing to substantiate a link between the two organizations. The Calabrian word Ndrangheta derives from Greek nu delta rho alpha gamma alpha theta alpha andragathia for heroism and manly virtue, or nu delta rho gamma alpha theta omicron sigma andragathos, compound words of nu rho, aner, i.e. man, and gamma alpha theta sigma, agathos, i.e. good, brave, meaning a courageous man. In many areas of Calabria, the verb ndrangetiari, from the Greek verb andragathis esti, means to engage in a defiant and valiant attitude. Though in recorded use earlier, the word Ndrangheta was brought to a wider audience by the Calabrian writer Corrado Alvaro in the Corriere della Sera in September 1955. Until 1975, the Ndrangheta restricted their Italian operations to Calabria, mainly involved in extortion and blackmailing. Their involvement in cigarette contraband expanded their scope and contacts with the Sicilian Mafia and the Neapolitan Camorra. With the arrival of large public works in Calabria, skimming of public contracts became an important source of income. Disagreements over how to distribute the spoils led to the first Ndrangheta war, killing 233 people. The prevailing factions began to kidnap rich people located in northern Italy for ransom. It is believed that John Paul Getty III, kidnapped for ransom in 1973, was one of their victims. The second Ndrangheta war raged from 1985 to 1991. The bloody six-year war between the Candelo Amerti Sereno Rosmini clans and the Di Stefano Tigano Libri Litello clans led to more than 600 deaths. The Sicilian Mafia contributed to the end of the conflict and probably suggested the subsequent setup of a superordinate body, called La Provincia, to avoid further infighting. In the 1990s, the organization started to invest in the illegal international drug trade, mainly importing cocaine from Colombia. Deputy President of the Regional Parliament of Calabria Francesco Forcigno was killed by the Ndrangheta on October 16, 2005 in Locri. Demonstrations against the organization then ensued, with young protesters carrying banderoles reading Amazzateci tutti, Italian for kill us all. The national government started a large-scale enforcement operation in Calabria and arrested numerous Ndranghetisti, including the murderers of Forcigno. The Ndrangheta has recently expanded its activities to northern Italy, mainly to sell drugs and to invest in legal businesses which could be used for money laundering. In May 2007, 20 members of Ndrangheta were arrested in Milan. On August 30, 2007, hundreds of police raided the town of San Luca, the focal point of the bitter San Luca feud between rival clans among the Ndrangheta. Over 30 men and women, linked to the killing of six Italian men in Germany, were arrested. On October 9, 2012, following a months-long investigation by the central government, The city council of Reggio Calabria headed by mayor was dissolved for alleged ties to the group. Arena and all the 30 city councillors were sacked to prevent any mafia contagion in the local government. This was the first time a government of a capital of a provincial government was dismissed. Three central government-appointed administrators will govern the city for 18 months until new elections. The move came after unnamed councillors were suspected of having ties to the Ndrangheta under the 10-year centre-right rule of Mayor Giuseppe Scopelliti. Ndrangheta infiltration of political offices is not limited to Calabria. On October 10, 2012, the commissioner of Milan's regional government in charge of public housing, Domenico Zambetti of People of Freedom, was arrested on accusations he paid the Ndrangheta in exchange for an election victory and to extort favors and contracts from the housing official, including construction tenders for the World Expo 2015 in Milan. The probe of alleged vote buying underscores the infiltration of the Ndrangheta in the political machine of Italy's affluent northern Lombardy region. Zambetti's arrest marked the biggest case of Ndrangheta infiltration so far uncovered in northern Italy and prompted calls for Lombardy governor Roberto Formigoni to resign. In 2014, in the FBI and Italian police joint operation New Bridge arrested members of both the Gambino and Bonanno families, as well as 10 members of the Ursino clan. Raffaele Valente was among the arrested. In Italian wiretaps, he revealed that he had set up a faction of the Ursino Ndrangheta in New York City. Valente was convicted for attempting to sell a sawed-off shotgun and a silencer to an undercover FBI agent for $5,000 at a bakery in Brooklyn. He was sentenced to 3 years and 1 month in prison. Gambino associate Franco Lupoi and his father-in-law, Nicola Antonio Simonetta, were described as the linchpins of the operation. In June 2014, Pope Francis denounced the Ndrangheta for their adoration of evil and contempt of the common good and vowed that the church would help tackle organized crime, saying that mafiosi were excommunicated. A spokesperson for the Vatican clarified that Pope's words did not constitute a formal excommunication under canon law, as a period of legal process is required beforehand. On December 12, 2017, 48 members of Ndrangheta were arrested for mafia association, extortion, criminal damage, fraudulent transfer of assets and illegal possession of firearms. Out of the 48 arrested, 4 were forced to house arrest and 44 were ordered to jail detention. Two-time mayor of Torrinova, Calabria and his former cabinet member were among the indicted. It was alleged by investigators that the Calabrian clan's hate infiltrated construction of public works, control of real estate brokerage, food fields, greenhouse production and renewable energy. On January 9, 2018, law enforcement in Italy and Germany arrested 169 people in connection with the Ndrangheta Mafia, specifically the Farao and Marincola clans based in Calabria. Assets worth 50 million euros were seized. The indictment mentions that owners of German restaurants, ice cream parlors, hotels and pizzerias were forced to buy wine, pizza dough, pastries and other products made in southern Italy. The Farao clan was being led by life-imprisoned Giuseppe Farao, before the arrests, and was passing orders on to his sons. They controlled bakeries, vineyards, olive groves, funeral homes, laundrettes, plastic recycling plants and shipyards. The waste disposal of the Ilva Steel Company based in Taranto was also infiltrated. Some of the charges were mafia association, attempted murder, money laundering, extortion and illegal weapons possession and trafficking. Italian prosecutor, Nicola Gratteri, said that the arrest is the most important step taken against the Ndrangheta within the past 20 years. 11 suspects were detained and accused of blackmailing and money laundering. They were deported back to Italy. Alessandro Filio Meni, former mayor of Siderno, Calabria, was sentenced to 12 years in prison on May 7, 2018. He is alleged to be a member of the Comiso Ndrina clan and served in the top hierarchy. Italian anti-organized crime agencies estimated in 2007 that the Ndrangheta has annual revenue of about €35-40 billion, which amounts to approximately 3.5% of the GDP of Italy. This comes mostly from illegal drug trafficking, but also from ostensibly legal businesses such as construction, restaurants and supermarkets. The Ndrangheta has a strong grip on the economy and governance in Calabria. According to a U.S. embassy cable leaked by WikiLeaks, Calabria would be a failed state if it were not part of Italy. The Ndrangheta controls huge segments of its territory and economy, and accounts for at least 3% of Italy's GDP through drug trafficking, extortion, skimming of public contracts, and usury. Law enforcement is hampered by a lack of both human and financial resources. The principal difference with the Mafia is in recruitment methods. The Ndrangheta recruits members on the criterion of blood relationships, resulting in an extraordinary cohesion within the family clan that presents a major obstacle to investigation. Sons of Ndranghetisti are expected to follow in their father's footsteps, and go through a grooming process in their youth to become Giovanni d'Onore before they eventually enter the ranks as Uomini d'Onore. There are relatively few Calabrian mafiosi who have opted out to become a pentito. At the end of 2002, there were 157 Calabrian witnesses in the state witness protection program. Unlike the Sicilian Mafia in the early 1990s, they have meticulously avoided a head-on confrontation with the Italian state. Prosecution in Calabria is hindered by the fact that Italian judges and prosecutors who score highly in exams get to choose their posting. Those who are forced to work in Calabria will usually request to be transferred right away. With weak government presence and corrupt officials, few civilians are willing to speak out against the organization. Both the Sicilian Cosa Nostra and the Ndrangheta are loose confederations of about 100 organized groups, also called kosher families, each of which claims sovereignty over a territory, usually a town or village, though without ever fully conquering and legitimizing its monopoly of violence. There are approximately 100 of these families, totaling between 4,000 and 5,000 members in Reggio Calabria. Other estimates mention 6,000 to 7,000 men. Worldwide there might be some 10,000 members. Most of the groups operate in the province of Reggio Calabria, although a portion of the recorded 70 criminal groups based in the Calabrian provinces Catanzaroa and Cosenza also appears to be formally affiliated with the Ndrangheta. The families are concentrated in poor villages in Calabria such as Plati, Locri, San Luca, Africo and Alto Mondi, as well as the main city and provincial capital Reggio Calabria. San Luca is considered to be the stronghold of the Ndrangheta. According to a former Ndranghetista, almost all the male inhabitants belong to the Ndrangheta, and the sanctuary of Polsi has long been the meeting place of the affiliates. Bosses from outside Calabria, from as far as Canada and Australia, regularly attend the meetings at the sanctuary of Polsi. The basic local organizational unit of the Ndrangheta is called a locale, with jurisdiction over an entire town or an area in a large urban center. A locale may have branches, called Ndrina, in the districts of the same city, in neighboring towns and villages, or even outside Calabria, in cities and towns in the industrial north of Italy in and around Turin and Milan, for example, Bardonecchia, an alpine town in the province of Turin in Piedmont, has been the first municipality in northern Italy dissolved for alleged mafia infiltration, with the arrest of the historical Ndrangheta boss of the city, Rocco Lopresti. The small towns of Corsico and Buccinasco in Lombardy are considered to be strongholds of the Ndrangheta. Sometimes sub-Ndrina are established. These sub-units enjoy a high degree of autonomy, they have a leader and independent staff. In some contexts the Ndrina have become more powerful than the locale on which they formally depend. Other observers maintain that the Ndrina is the basic organizational unit. Each Ndrina is autonomous on its territory and no formal authority stands above the Ndrina boss, according to the Anti-Mafia Commission. The Ndrina is usually in control of a small town or a neighborhood. If more than one Ndrina operates in the same town, they form a locale. Blood family and membership of the crime family overlap to a great extent within the Ndrangheta. By and large, the Ndrina consist of men belonging to the same family lineage. Salvatore Boemi, anti-mafia prosecutor in Reggio Calabria, told the Italian Anti-Mafia Commission that one becomes a member for the simple fact of being born in a mafia family, although other reasons might attract a young man to seek membership, and non-kin have also been admitted. Marriages help cement relations within each Ndrina and to expand membership. As a result, a few blood families constitute each group, hence a high number of people with the same last name often end up being prosecuted for membership of a given Ndrina. Indeed, since there is no limit to the membership of a single unit, bosses try to maximize descendants. At the bottom of the chain of command are the picchiati d'onore or soldiers, who are expected to perform tasks with blind obedience until they are promoted to the next level of camorrista, where they will be granted command over their own group of soldiers. The next level, separated by the Ndrina but Brutaf and Ndrangheta, is known as Santista and higher still as the Vengialista, upon which the up-and-coming gangster has to swear their dedication to a life off crime on the Bible. The Quintino, also called Padrino, is the second highest level of command in a Ndrangheta clan, being made up of five privileged members of the crime family who report directly to the boss, the Capobastan. For many years, The power apparatus of the single families were the sole ruling bodies within the two associations, and they have remained the real centers of power even after superordinate bodies were created in the Cosa Nostra beginning in the 1950s and in the Ndrangheta. Superordinate body was created only in 1991 as the result of negotiations to end years of inter-family violence. Unlike the Sicilian Mafia, the Ndrangheta managed to maintain a horizontal organizational structure up to the early 1990s, avoiding the establishment of a formal superordinate body. Information of several witnesses has undermined the myth of absolute autonomy of Calabrian crime families, however. At least since the end of the 19th century, stable mechanisms for coordination and dispute settlement were created. Contacts and meetings among the bosses of the locally were frequent. A new investigation, known as Operation Crimini, which ended in July 2010 with an arrest of 305 Ndrangheta members, revealed that the Ndrangheta was extremely hierarchical, united and pyramidal, and not just clan-based as previously believed, as said by Italy's chief anti-mafia prosecutor Piero Grasso. At least since the 1950s, the chiefs of the Ndrangheta locally have met regularly near the sanctuary of Our Lady of Pulci in the municipality of San Luca during September feast. These annual meetings, known as the Crimini, have traditionally served as a forum to discuss future strategies and settle disputes among the locally. The assembly exercises weak supervisory powers over the activities of all Ndrangheta groups. Strong emphasis was placed on the temporary character of the position of the Crimini boss. A new representative was elected at each meeting. Far from being the boss of the bosses, the Capo Crimini actually has comparatively little authority to interfere in family feuds or to control the level of interfamily violence. At these meetings, every boss must give account of all the activities carried out during the year and of all the most important facts taking place in his territory, such as kidnappings, homicides, etc. The historical preeminence of the San Luca family is such that every new group or locale must obtain its authorization to operate, and every group belonging to the Ndrangheta still has to deposit a small percentage of illicit proceeds to the Principal of San Luca in recognition of the latter's primordial supremacy. Security concerns have led to the creation in the Ndrangheta of a secret society within the secret society, La Santa. Membership in the Santa is only known to other members. Contrary to the code, it allowed bosses to establish close connections with state representatives, even to the extent that some were affiliated with the Santa. These connections were often established through the Freemasonry, which the Santisti, breaking another rule of the traditional code, were allowed to join. Since the end of the Second Ndrangheta War in 1991, the Ndrangheta is ruled by a collegial body or commission, known as La Provincia. Its primary function is the settlement of inter-family disputes. The body, also referred to as the commission in reference to its Sicilian counterpart, is composed of three lower bodies, known as mandamenti. One for the clans on the Ionic side of Calabria, a second for the Tyrrhenian side, and one central mandamento for the city of Reggio Calabria. According to Italian Dion Guardia di Finanza, the Ndrangheta is now one of the most powerful criminal organizations in the world. Economic activities of Ndrangheta include international cocaine and weapons smuggling, with Italian investigators estimating that 80% of Europe's cocaine passes through the Calabrian port of Gioia Tauro and is controlled by the Ndrangheta. However, according to a report of the European Monitoring Center for Drugs and Drug Addiction and Europol, the Iberian Peninsula is considered the main entry point for cocaine into Europe and a gateway to the European market. The United Nations Office on Drugs and Crime estimated that in 2007 nearly 10 times as much cocaine was intercepted in Spain in comparison with Italy. Ndrangheta groups and Sicilian Cosa Nostra groups sometimes act as joint ventures in cocaine trafficking enterprises. Further activities include skimming money off large public work construction projects, money laundering, and traditional crimes such as usury and extortion. Ndrangheta invests illegal profits in legal real estate and financial activities. In early February 2017, the Carabinieri arrested 33 suspects in the Calabrian Mafia's Baram Alindrina, which was allegedly exporting fake extra virgin olive oil to the U.S. The product was actually inexpensive olive pomace oil fraudulently labeled. In early 2016, the American television program 60 Minutes had warned that the olive oil business has been corrupted by the mafia and that agro-mafia was $16 billion per year enterprise. The business volume of the Ndrangheta is estimated at almost 44 billion euro in 2007, approximately 2.9% of Italy's GDP, according to Eurisps in Italy. Drug trafficking is the most profitable activity with 62% of the total turnover. The Ndrangheta has had a remarkable ability to establish branches abroad, mainly through migration. The overlap of blood and mafia family seems to have helped the Ndrangheta expand beyond its traditional territory. The familial bond has not only worked as a shield to protect secrets and enhance security, but also helped to maintain identity in the territory of origin and reproduce it in territories where the family has migrated. Ndrangheta are reported to be operating in northern Italy, Germany, Belgium, the Netherlands, France, the rest of Europe, the United States, Canada, and Australia. One group of Ndranghetistas discovered outside Italy was in Ontario, Canada, several decades ago. They were dubbed the Siderno group by Canadian judges as most of its members hailed from and around Siderno. Magistrates in Calabria sounded the alarm a few years ago about the international scale of the Ndrangheta's operations. It is now believed to have surpassed the traditional axis between the Sicilian and American Cosa Nostra, to become the major importer of cocaine to Europe. Outside Italy, Ndrangheta operates in several countries, such as: in November 2006, a cocaine trafficking network that operated in Argentina, Spain and Italy was dismantled. The Argentinian police said the Ndrangheta had roots in the country and shipped cocaine through Spain to Milan and Turin. Known by the name The Honored Society, the Ndrangheta controlled Italian-Australian organized crime all along the east coast of Australia since the early 20th century. Ndrangheta operating in Australia include the Sergi, Barbaro and Papalia clans. Similarly, in Victoria, the major families are named as Italiano, Arena, Moratore, Benvenuto, and Candelo. In the 1960s, warfare among Ndrangheta clans broke out over the control of the Victoria market in Melbourne, where an estimated $45 million worth of fruits and vegetables passed through each year. After the death of Domenico Italiano, known as Il Papa, different clans tried to gain control over the produce market. At the time, it was unclear that most involved were affiliated with the Ndrangheta. The Ndrangheta began in Australia in Queensland, where they continued their form of rural organized crime, especially in the fruit and vegetable industry. After the 1998-2006 Melbourne gangland killings, which included the murder of Ndrangheta godfather Frank Benvenuto. In 2008, the Ndrangheta were tied to the importation of 15 million ecstasy pills to Melbourne, at the time the world's largest ecstasy haul. The pills were hidden in a container load of tomato cans from Calabria. Australian Ndrangheta boss Pasquale Barbaro was arrested. Pasquale Barbaro's father Francesco Barbaro was a boss throughout the 1970s and early 1980s until his retirement. Several of the Barbaro clan, including among others, Francesco, were suspected in orchestrating the murder of Australian businessman Donald Mackay in July 1977 for his anti-drugs campaign. Italian authorities believe that former Western Australian mayor of the city of Stirling, Tony Vallelonga, is an associate of Giuseppe Comiso, boss of the Siderno clan of the Ndrangheta. In 2009, Italian police overheard the two discussing Ndrangheta activities. Since migrating from Italy to Australia in 1963, Vallelonga has established a long career in grassroots politics. The Ndrangheta are also tied to large cocaine imports. Up to 500 kilograms of cocaine was documented relating to the mafia and Australian associates smuggled in slabs of marble, plastic tubes and canned tuna, coming from South America to Melbourne via Italy between 2002 and 2004. Ndrangheta clans purchase almost an entire neighborhood in Brussels with laundered money originating from drug trafficking. On March 5, 2004, 47 people were arrested, accused of drug trafficking and money laundering to purchase real estate in Brussels for some 28 million euros. The activities extended to the Netherlands, where large quantities of heroin and cocaine had been purchased by the Pesbelaco clan from Rosarno and the Strongio clan from San Luca. Forces of the Brazilian Polícia Federal have linked illegal drug trading activities in Brazil to Ndrangheta in Operation Monte Polino, which disassembled cocaine exportation schemes to Europe. According to a May 2018 news report, Siderno's Old World Ndrangheta boss sent acolytes to populate the New World, including Michel Rocco, who settled in Toronto in 1952, followed by other mob families. By 2010, investigators in Italy said that Toronto's Ndrangheta had climbed to the top of the criminal world with an unbreakable umbilical cord to Calabria. In recent years, the Canadian Ndrangheta is believed to be involved in various activities, including the smuggling of unlicensed tobacco products through teas with criminal elements in cross-border Native American tribes. According to Alberto Cisterna of the Italian National Anti-Mafia Directorate, the Ndrangheta has a heavy presence in Canada. There is a massive number of their people in North America, especially in Toronto, and for two reasons. The first is linked to the banking system. Canada's banking system is very secretive, it does not allow investigation, so Canada is the ideal place to launder money. The second reason is to smuggle drugs. The Ndrangheta have found Canada a useful North American entry point. A Canadian branch labeled the Siderno Group, because its members primarily came from the Ionian coastal town of Siderno in Calabria, is the one discussed earlier, active in Canada since the 1950s. Siderno is also home to one of the Ndrangheta's biggest and most important clans, heavily involved in the global cocaine business and money laundering. Antonio Comiso, the alleged leader of the Siderno Group, is reported to lead efforts to import illicit arms, explosives and drugs. Elements of Ndrangheta have been reported to have been present in Hamilton, Ontario as early as 1911. Historical crime families in the Hamilton area include the Musitanos, Mapinos, and Papalias. After living in Richmond Hill, Ontario for 5 years until 2010, Antonio Coluccio was one of 29 people named in arrest warrants in Italy in September 2014. Police said they were part of the Comiso Ndrina crime family in Siderno. In July 2018, Coluccio was sentenced to 30 years in prison for corruption. His two brothers, including Salvatore and Giuseppe Coluccio, were already in prison due to mafia-related convictions. In June 2015, RCMP led police raids across the Greater Toronto area, named Project A Phoenix, which resulted in the arrest of 19 men, allegedly affiliated with the Ndrangheta. In March 2018, during the resultant criminal trial north of Toronto, the court heard from a Carabinieri lieutenant colonel that Ndrangheta is active in Germany, Australia and the Greater Toronto area. People in Italy have to be responsible for their representatives here, but the final word comes from Italy. A member of the Greater Toronto area's Ndrangheta cell, Carmen Guido, who had been a police informant, testified at length about the structure and activities of the organization, which had been under the control of Italian-born Bradford, Ontario resident, Giuseppe Ursino and Romanian-born Cosmin Drissi of Toronto. The latter two faced 2 counts of cocaine trafficking for the benefit of a criminal organization and 1 charge of conspiracy to commit an indictable offense. Guido was paid $2.4 million by the Royal Canadian Mounted Police between 2013 and 2015 to secretly tape dozens of conversations with suspected Ndrangheta members. The organization used extortion, loan sharking, theft, electoral crimes, mortgage and bank fraud, crimes of violence and cocaine trafficking. According to an agreed statement of fact filed with the court, the local cells, outside of Calabria replicate the structure from Calabria, and are connected to their mother locally in Calabria. The authority to start locally outside Calabria comes from the governing bodies of the organization in Calabria. The locally outside of Calabria are part of the same Ndrangheta organization as in Calabria, and maintain close relationships with the locally where its members come from. The group's activities in the Greater Toronto area were controlled by a group known as the Camerati Controllo, which makes all of the final decisions, according to the witness testimony. The reference to La Provincia / Camerati Controllo was also made in previous years. News reports discussed 6 or 7 Toronto area men, who coordinated activities and resolved disputes among Calabrian gangsters in southern Ontario. One of the members, Giuseppe Coluccio, was arrested in Ontario, extradited to Italy and convicted. Other alleged La Provincia members included Rocco Zito before his death, Carmen Verduzzi before his death, and Cosimo Staltieri before his death. In June 2018, Cosimo Ernesto Comiso, of Woodbridge, Ontario, and an unrelated woman were shot and killed. According to sources contacted by the Toronto Star, Comiso was related to Cosimo the Quail Comiso of Siderno, Italy, who has had relations in Ontario, is considered by police to be Ndrangheta organized crime boss. The National Post reported that Cosimo Ernesto Comiso, while not a known criminal, shares a name and family ties with a man who has for decades been reputed to be a mafia leader in the Toronto area. The cousin of the Quail, Antonio Comiso, was on the list of most wanted fugitives in Italy until his capture on June 28, 2005, in Woodbridge. The Ndrangheta clans were closely associated with the AUC paramilitary groups led Salvatore Mancuso, a son of Italian immigrants. He surrendered to Alvaro Uribe's government to avoid extradition to the U.S. according to Giuseppe Lumia of the Italian Parliamentary Anti-Mafia Commission, Ndrangheta clans are actively involved in the production of cocaine. According to a study by the German Foreign Intelligence Service, the Bundesnachrichtendienst, Ndrangheta groups are using Germany to invest cash from drugs and weapons smuggling. Profits are invested in hotels, restaurants and houses, especially along the Baltic coast and in the eastern German states off Thuringia and Saxony. Investigators believe that the mafia's bases in Germany are used primarily for clandestine financial transactions. In 1999, the State Office of Criminal Investigation in Stuttgart investigated an Italian from San Luca who had allegedly laundered millions through a local bank, the Sparkasse Ulm. The man claimed that he managed a profitable car dealership, and authorities were unable to prove that the business was not the source of his money. The Bundeskriminalamt concluded in 2000 that the activities of this Ndrangheta clan represent a multi-regional criminal phenomenon. In 2009, a confidential report by the BKA said some 229 Ndrangheta families were living in Germany, and were involved in gun running, money laundering, drug dealing, and racketeering, as well as legal businesses. Some 900 people were involved in criminal activity, and were also legal owners of hundreds of restaurants, as well as being major players in the property market in the former East. The most represented Ndrangheta family originated from the city of San Luca, with some 200 members in Germany. A war between the two Ndrangheta clans Paleromeo and Strongio Nerda from San Luca that had started in 1991 and resulted in several deaths spilled into Germany in 2007. Six men were shot to death in front of an Italian restaurant in Duisburg on August 15, 2007. According to the head of the German Federal Police Service, Jörg Zierk, half of the criminal groups identified in Germany belong to the Ndrangheta. It has been the biggest criminal group since the 1980s. Compared to other groups operating in Germany, the Italians have the strongest organization. Allegedly lived for 10 years in the Netherlands, where he managed his contacts with Colombian cocaine cartels. He was arrested in Amsterdam on 27 October 2005. The seaports of Rotterdam and Amsterdam are used to import cocaine. The Giorgi, Nerda and Strongio clans from San Luca have a base in the Netherlands and Brussels. In March 2012, the head of the Dutch National Crime Squad stated that the DNR will team up with the Tax and Customs Administration and the Fiscal Information and Investigation Service to combat the Ndrangheta. David Gunzi, a son of former Prime Minister of Malta Lawrence Gunzi, was accused of illegal activities by acting as a trustee shareholder in a gaming company. The company in question was operated by a Calabrian associate of the Ndrangheta in Malta. His name appeared several times on an investigation document of over 750 pages that was commissioned by the Tribunal of the Reggio Calabria. Gunzi called the document unprofessional. A European arrest warrant was published for Gunzi to appear at the tribunal, but this never materialized. Gunzi, however, was completely exonerated from the list of potential suspects in the Ndrangheta gaming bust. After investigation of the presence of the Ndrangheta, 21 gaming outlets had their operation license temporarily suspended in Malta due to irregularities in a period of 1 year. In a notice of the conclusion of the investigation dated 30 June 2016, criminal action was commenced in Italy against 113 persons originally mentioned in the investigation. The Ndrangheta works in conjunction with a Mexican drug cartel mercenary army known as Los Zetas in the drug trade. In February 2018, Slovak investigative journalist Jan Kušek was shot dead at his home together with his fiancée. At the time of the murder, Kušek was working on a report about the activities of Ndrangheta in Slovakia, including its ties to Slovak politicians. The crime syndicate has a significant presence in Switzerland since the early 1970s but has operated there with little scrutiny due to the inconspicuous lifestyles of their members, the Swiss legal landscape, and solid foundations in local businesses. In the aftermath of the San Luca feud in 2007 and subsequent arrests in Italy, it became clear that the group had also infiltrated the economically proliferous regions of Switzerland and southern Germany. In March 2016, Swiss law enforcement in cooperation with Italian state prosecutors arrested a total of 15 individuals, 13 in the city of Frauenfeld, 2 in the canton of Valais, accusing them of active membership to an organized crime syndicate also known as Operazione Helvetica. Since 2015, the Swiss Federal Police has conducted undercover surveillance and recorded the group's meetings in a restaurant establishment in a small village just outside of Frauenfeld. The meetings were taking place in a relatively remote location using the now-defunct entity the Wangi Boccia Club as its cover. According to the Italian prosecutor Antonio De Bernardo, there are several cells operating within the jurisdiction of the Swiss Federation, estimating the number of operatives per cell to about 40, and a couple of 100 in total. All of the arrested persons are Italian citizens. The two men arrested in Thvale have already been extradited to Italy, and as of August 2016, one individual arrested in Frauenfeld has been approved for extradition to Italy. In London, the Arakri and Fazeri clans are thought to be active in money laundering, catering and drug trafficking. The earliest evidence of Ndrangheta activity in the U.S. points to an intimidation scheme run by the syndicate in Pennsylvania mining towns. This scheme was unearthed in 1906. Current Ndrangheta activities in America mainly involve drug trafficking, arms smuggling, and money laundering. It is known that the Ndrangheta branches in North America have been associating with Italian-American organized crime. The Saracci family from Reggio Calabria has moved some of its operations to the U.S. The family was founded by Giuseppe Saracci, who has been in the United States since 1962. His younger cousin, Antonio Rogliana, runs the family in Calabria. On Tuesday, February 11, 2014, both FBI and Italian police intercepted the transatlantic network of U.S. and Italian crime families. The raid targeted the Gambino and Bonanno families in the U.S. while in Italy, it targeted the Ursino Ndrina from Gioiosa Gianica. The defendants were charged with drug trafficking, money laundering and firearms offenses, based, in part, on their participation in a transnational heroin and cocaine trafficking conspiracy involving the Ndrangheta. The operation began in 2012 when investigators detected a plan by members of the Ursino clan of the Ndrangheta to smuggle large amounts of drugs. An undercover agent was dispatched to Italy and was successful in infiltrating the clan. An undercover agent was also involved in the handover of 1.3 kilograms of heroin in New York as part of the infiltration operation. Beginning in 2000, music producer released three CD compilations of Italian mafia folk songs over a five-year period. Collectively known as, these compilations consist mainly of songs written by Ndrangheta musicians, often sung in Calabrian and dealing with themes such as vengeance, betrayal, justice within the Ndrangheta, and the ordeal of prison life. Thanks for watching. Don't forget like the video and don't forget to subscribe.